the songs and the emotion of those songs are so pure and never diminished in your passion for how they made you feel, how much you love them to this day. So now imagine the orchestrated version. Ooh-wee. That's just such an amazing feat to add to your history books. That's, you know, mapped out as just your road. You know what I'm saying? Other people may come along and be on that road with you, but you're the original driver. The eyes were on Nas at that time, big time. It was on him, like him and Big L. Big L too. Nas obviously on a different scale, you know, but Big L too. Because they had both gotten signed at the same time. I was there when they were both signing their contracts, just going to CBS just to pick up vinyl because I was on the radio at the time. I was picking up my promos to find stuff to play for the mix show. So they happened to be in the conference room signing their contracts. We knew that it was gonna be that big of a deal. That's why I never understood why I didn't go like super platinum quick. I thought it was gonna go like super fast, and it didn't. You know, he outsold that one with the, like, It Was Written and other albums. Well, I thought this one was gonna be a big platinum album. And we were like, man, just stay gold. But at the same time, gold really is platinum to an Illmatic. It really is. It's like, you know, when we got our first Gangstar goal, we're like, yo, we are huge. You know what I'm saying? It felt like 7 million, but it was like, it's good. That 500,000 meant a lot in our world. Just like in the hip hop early days, driving a Jetta, or, you know, was like having a Rolls Royce. We had already done Represent, but not the one on the album. The one on the album is a remix. Once we got to me hearing One Love and Life's a, I was like, yo, I gotta update mine. In New York State of Mind, it was literally him watching me drop the needle and, what do you think of that? You like that? And that's all right. Okay, keep going. And like, you know, it's records, so I'm like bringing it back to that point where I think it needs to start. Boom, we're just like, ooh. I said, hold on, let me hook that up. The sound that ran hip hop was our sound. Nas matched that. It wasn't like, ah, shorty, get your sound up. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't get your sound up. It's like, he blends right in. Come on, youngster. The orchestra stuff, just now that gives you the color. The color has to be there to really feel it. And then I love how they did the interludes and structures of, you know, segueing into another song. Like, even when I'm like looking at the order, like, this don't sound like my joint. This don't sound like Lost Professor. This don't sound like Pete. And all of a sudden it starts coming, you're like, ooh. And he looks the correct, you know, way to present himself as an MC, and say there's no Tim Boots in this one, you know. I like how he's always used the same cover, but this one actually, besides the original, is the best looking one to me. It just looks dope, man. Gold on the back. Can't never go bad on gold, man. But that's the one thing that makes the Illmatic album so dope, because not only is it long-lasting in every era, it has that many legs that it's like, you know, let's keep putting more legs on it.